Well, it's an ancient debate. It goes all the way back to the ancient Greeks about the origin of life. Is it the result of a purely undirected process, a material process, or was a designing agent or intelligence involved in some way? And that's an ancient debate, and it's popped up all over again.
Richard Dawkins has talked about this debate. Which side is he on?
Well, he's on what we call the materialist side. He thinks the undirected processes have done it. He says that biology is actually the study of complicated things that give the appearance of having been designed for a purpose, where the key word is for Dawkins, appearance. Things look designed, but they're not really designed. They don't owe their origin to an actual intelligent designer of any kind.
And Francisco Ayala, he also has said that, and he's past president of what?
American Association for the Advancement of Science. And he says that it was Darwin's greatest accomplishment to show that the directive organization of living things can be explained as the result of a natural process, natural selection, without any need to invoke a designer or creator of any kind. Another place he says that Darwin gave us design, the appearance of design, without a designer.
Now, give me the other side.
Well, the alternative view is the theory of intelligent design, which says that living things give the appearance of design because they really are designed, and that you can tell when you examine the scientific evidence. The theory of intelligent design is a pretty simple idea at root. It's the idea that we can detect the activity of intelligent agency in the effects that they leave behind. If you go to Mount Rushmore, for example, you see the beautiful faces on the mountains there, and you realize that a sculptor played a role. Now, inside cells, we don't have little sculpted faces, but we have other indicators of intelligence, digital code, complex nanotechnology, little tiny miniature machines, things that we would in any other realm of experience attribute to intelligence. So our argument is that what we see in biology doesn't give just the appearance of design, it's actually giving us evidence of an actual designing intelligence.
This has been an ATRI production.